night. See him on the TV preaching about the promised lands. He tells me believing Jesus steals the money from my hands.
Someone caught and ate an alligator gar. Look at this. Now, what my buddy, who we went, I caught one of these before, Stay River. They're huge. The one I caught was 4 feet. My buddy told me you can't even go near the mouth because the teeth, see how the teeth stick outside the mouth? And if it slides sideways on you, you still get cut. And it's so true. Look at that. This is one of 5 boat launches that are in my neighborhood. They're all free, but they're day use only. I saw this sign and I'm like, what is going on here? Why can't you, this clearly isn't a road. Why can't you park between these two signs, right? Then I realized it's to back up for the boat launch. So, it's concrete. Most of them are gravel. This is a lot of them are really steep because you'd have to make them very, very long with the 5 foot drop in water between summer and winter pooling. Like you can see right here where the water typically is all the way up here. But yeah, this is concrete all the way in. So this is a pretty nice launch. Look at this. And this is all in the national forest too. So this road goes out on the bay pretty far, like another 3 miles, but you have to cross through a really deep river and a pool over there, and it's all mud. I'm not going to try to do it when it's been raining all morning, so we are not going to try that today. However, if you brought your dog here and you're walking and you just walk to the other side of that creek, no one else would follow you. It's because it's such a hard obstacle to get to. Because one thing I have learned in the forest here, the rain never hits you. It just doesn't get through. Yeah, look how dry the ground is right here. Even though it's been raining all morning. Hey, Riv. I don't have boots on, so I'm looking down at the ground as I'm walking. I'm not looking ahead. Which is how you run into bears, but avoid snakes. Look at the moss growing in the grass on the other side there. Oh, look at that shit. This is really cool. Now imagine 5 more feet of water brings it right up here to the shoreline. This would be a perfect little spot during the summer when the water's high. That cypress stump, that would have been a gorgeous tree out there. They probably had to cut it because it was right in the middle of the river.
I'm nothing but a low life, thinking about my old life. I can't help myself from falling, can't help myself from falling. I'm nothing but a low life, thinking about my old life. I'm trying to fight the good old fight, but after it all, I'm still just a low life.
God, I need to cut her nails. That's what the dinghy looks like when it's messy. Front part has got a little bit of a leak where you have to pump it up every few days, and right now it's obviously, I haven't been here for a while, so it's drained. I cannot explain how much of my, like a percentage wise, how much fun I have in this dinghy versus everything else. Like, this by far is the best bang for the buck. If you're only going to spend a couple $1,000s on a boat, just buy one of these. Something like this, and you can go anywhere with it. You can pack it up with camping gear. You can get on any river with it. You can buy any kind of motor to propel it, you know? So this seat with these pockets, number one, it kind of helped me when we go on the long distances. That seat's not the most comfortable seat to be on. However, it is on two air tubes. So when we hit big waves, the air tubes are shock absorbers for you. So you're not hitting, you're not just, you know, basically you're bouncing more than anything. But I think this little cushion will help a little bit. And then all the pouches, I can put a bunch of different stuff in. So I like that. And then this is the new pump. Essentially, where do they show it? This little piece right here broke, one of them broke on each one of the pumps that I had.
Don't stop even for the right thing. Doesn't matter what I say. My whole world was by that river, blowing off to meet the sea each day. I don't want to move away. Look at me and you say, what's wrong, boy? What else do you want me to say?
GPS. Look at it's trying to get into my sailboat. Look at this fucking snake. If this damn thing gets into my sailboat, I'm gonna have a heart attack, dude. Look at it trying to get in the sailboat. Oh my fucking god. Look at it. Okay, so it's just sitting there. It's not going off. It's just sitting there. Oh, it's using the rope. Okay, so it's going. It used the GPS to get out of the water, and now it's using the rope to go up on the boat. And it is moving, yeah, now it's all the way out of the water. It's on the rope now. Look at that! Okay, that's good to know. I need to move that rope. Alright, I'm gonna go deal with that shit. That did not just happen right in front of me.
I'm on the sailboat now. Oh shit, any noise. Oh my god, that freaked me out. So the noise from the dock sounded like a hiss, and I just screamed like a little bitch. My guess is if I... There he goes. He just jumped off of the rope. All right, we're going to put this inside the boat. Good luck getting on the boat now, sir.
After a month being on this boat without being able to hose it down and wash it off, it really needs to be cleaned. I mean, River's paw prints are everywhere. My shoe prints are everywhere. Even Cricket has paw prints everywhere. So we're going to wash it down.
It's brooding Alabama at the Colonial Inn. Hot day old orange juice and vodka on a nightstand. Bella Chevy Nova with the seat burned out the back from a Winston cigarette that was dumped into the window. Bobby Long was like Zorba the Greek.
There is just a level of clean on the other side of a pressure washer. Man. She looks good again. So much hair and sand all over that boat. Man, really needed a good wash down. I took this picture the other day and I came back here with River just to run him. And I noticed something while I was looking at the picture. That is a very clear cut example of the difference in height. That's 5 feet right there. So they drop 5 feet of water.
So here's a map of where Morgan Creek is where I'm at right now. Eagle Creek is where we were at last episode. The marina is where we're staying currently. And my property is right in the middle there. Just gives you an idea of where everything is.
I came here in my houseboat for several weeks. I stayed on that island, I stayed on that island, I stayed in the bay over here for a day. River and I walked here once or twice, but I never knew that there was a road that would bring us in here, and I just found it, and that's really cool. I saw it on the map the other day.
This right here, you see how this tree is right here? I would have to go forwards and backwards and forwards and backwards to get around this turn here. This is what's called a tight turn maneuver, right? So what I do in this situation is I lock my rear differential, pull my foot on my brakes, give it gas. And it kicks the back end around while holding the front still.
When all your good days are getting short.